In this video, I'm going to show you how to create some lighting effects in Node-RED, similar to Hue Labs. Make sure you stick around, and if you like what you see, hit subscribe below so you don't miss out on future videos. Hi, I'm Will from Will Surridge Tech, and in this video, we're going to look at how we can use Node-RED to replace some Hue Labs effects. We're going to talk about what Hue Labs is, and then we'll pick out a few which we can recreate using Node-RED. So let's get going. So what is Hue Labs? Well, Hue Labs is a place where you can do extra things with your Hue light bulbs. It's inside the Hue app, and it was designed by Philips to effectively beta test some features that they might want to implement later down the line. Although I haven't really seen any of the formulas implemented later down the line. That being said, they might have done and I might have missed them. A formula is what they call an effect, or an automation, or a routine, or whatever you want to call them. If we head over to the Hue Labs website, we can see all the formulas available to choose. Some of these you can see require motion sensors or switches to work. If we're recreating in Node-RED and using Home Assistant, we can use any switch or motion sensor, irrelevant of the brand, which is a great little bonus. So let's have a look at some of these examples. This is meditation breathing, where your breathing fades to the lights. No, it doesn't. Your lights fade to the breathing. No, you breathe as the lights fade. There we go. We've got briefly bright, which is where it goes briefly bright and then returns to the same scene afterwards. We've got sensing the weekend, where it'll choose a different scene based on your button press if it's the weekend, instead of it being the week. As you can see, some of these are going to be really easy to recreate in Node-RED, and some of them are going to be more difficult, but all of them are possible. So let's try recreating that first one in Node-RED. For all these examples, I'm just going to trigger them using an inject node. But you could also trigger them using a motion sensor, a switch, a boolean, or whatever you want, depending on what you're trying to achieve with the effect. So this is guided breathing. The point in it is that you breathe as the lights fade in, and you breathe out as the lights fade out. It's a very simple one to recreate. For this, we're going to need an inject node to trigger it, a couple of cool service nodes, and a couple of delay nodes, and we're just going to create a simple loop with them. So our first cool service node, we're going to set the light that we want, and then in the data, we're going to set it to be at full brightness, at color of white, and with a transition of 6 seconds. This means it will slowly fade along with your breathing. We're then going to set the delay to be 7 seconds. The delay will actually trigger at the start of the transition and not after it's finished fading. We then, in the second cool service node, we're going to drop the brightness right down, and we're going to change the color slightly so it's got a bit more of a blue tint to it. Again, we have a delay of 7 seconds, which will start at the start of the transition, and then we'll loop back to the beginning. And there we have a slowly pulsing light. Next up, we're going to try and recreate the briefly bright scene. So this one is where you have a state on, and then you suddenly want it to go bright, and then return back to that original state after a period of time. You might find this useful for your outside lighting. If you have a nice ambient setup outside for while you're inside, but then if you wanted to take the bins out, for example, you need going to need a bit more light. So you make the lights go bright, and then after a couple of minutes, they dim back down again, back to what it was. So for this to work, we're going to need an inject node to trigger it, or whatever else you want to trigger it with, a current state node, a cool service node, then we're going to want a delay node, a function node, and a cool service node to return it. In our current state node, we're going to grab the information of our current lighting state from the light and save it in the message.data section. We then trigger the cool service node, which is going to make our lights go bright and white. And then in a separate path, we have a delay. I'm just going to set this for 5 seconds for the purpose of this. But obviously, once it's up and running, you'd want to set it for a couple of minutes or so, depending on what you're using it for. We then use the function node to extract the data from the message.data and input it in the data section of the message.payload. This means that our final cool service node will read that data and input that into what it's going to cool as the service. So it will extract our brightness and our RGB color value. And then it will input that into our cool service node so we can re-trigger that original light and it'll go back to the state that it was originally. You can expand this function as you see fit, from just being one light to a whole number of lights, or even expand it further and use it on a media player, for example. For example, if you wanted to, I don't know, pause the music, announce a text-to-speech announcement, and then return to the music that was playing. Now, the last routine I'm going to show you today is going to be a little bit more complicated. We're going to create a guided workout with our lights. So to do this, we're going to need our inject node, a small delay node. This is just so we can link back to one node rather than having to link back to two. Then we have a longer delay node, and then we can start the workout section. So we're going to have a loop node, and then we can have a function node to cool the color, a couple of cool state nodes, and a couple of delay nodes. In the loop node, we set the max number of loops to the number of times we want to repeat this exercise. Then in the function node, we're going to set the message.payload to recall the color that we want to be using. This means that we only have to do it once and it'll apply to this whole section of flow, rather than having to do it repeatedly. We're then going to, in the first cool service node, change our light to full brightness, and then have a couple of seconds delay, and then we're going to change our light to dim and have another couple of seconds delay. The point in this is for an exercise such as a push-up, where you go up when the light is bright and down when the light is dim, for example. Once that's repeated the max number of loops times, then it will move on to the second section, or the second output from your loop node. Here, we're going to have a cool service node to turn our light off and add a 10 second delay. When the light is off, we know we can rest, so we're just going to have a 10 second rest here before moving on to the next exercise. We can copy all of this and paste it below, but this time we're going to change the color to blue. That means we know it's a new exercise. We copy and paste again, changing the color to red, and that's our three exercises. So at the end, we want another turning the light off in a cool service node and another 10 second delay. And then we're going to add a counter and a switch. This is going to tell us how many sets of these three exercises we're going to do. If the counter is less than three, then it will go back to the start and repeat the set. However, when it gets more than three, it'll jump off and do a separate thing entirely. Now let's take this one step further. It's not really a guided workout if we're not told what to do. So we're going to use the Alexa Media Player to do a text-to-speech to tell us what exercise we're going to do. So we're going to use the Notify Alexa Media Player for the echo that we want to display on. And then we're going to use the JSON, which I've copied directly from the GitHub for the Alexa Media Player, and just replace the message with the exercise. We copy and paste this for all three exercises and changing the message, and then at the end for a well done message to tell us that we're done. And then for a bit of fun, let's add some disco lights at the end. To do this, we're going to use the Hue Magic node and use the strobo animation on a Hue bulb. We're also going to want to set a delay and then change our payload to an input boolean to false to stop that animation happening, just so they flash for a little bit and then go off. So that's three Hue Labs formulas recreated in Node-RED. I'll leave a link below to where you can find the full JSON for all of the flows that I've created today. Obviously, the flows I've made it have been quite specific, but you can tweak them, tweak the timings, tweak the lights, tweak the settings to whatever you want. Or you can just use it as some inspiration to create your own flows. It goes to show how easy and how versatile Node-RED can be. Thank you to Grim Roper for the idea. And if anyone else has any ideas of videos you'd like me to make, please let me know in the comments below or in a message on my social media. And there we go. Who needs the Hue app? Make sure you hit subscribe and click the bell icon below to find out more about my smart tech and how you can build yourself the ultimate smart home.